on four.
Hi, folks. Welcome to another edition of the Royal Ramblings. And today I have something very special to talk about. I actually went out tonight with one of my friends, and I experienced something that I was not really that familiar with, and I was very excited. It was very, very cool to see something new, and I'm going to share it with you guys because I actually have my friend here with me. Now, due to the sensitive nature of a few of the things that we're going to talk about, which you'll understand a little bit better once we get into it, he has decided that it would not be to his best interest to be on camera, but we're going to interview him now. Make sure that you speak
up.
Okay, you speak up. All right, and actually what the subject of this ramblings is going to be about is the expertise that my friend has been in. It's something in the casinos, the game of craps, and it's about dice control, about being able to control dice, which is probably, this is the first time a lot of you guys will hear about it. It's something new to me. A lot of controversy there as to whether or not it's something that you can or can't do, but because it's foreign to me and probably many of you in the audience, I'm just going to go ahead and ask my special guest my first question. What is dice control?
Okay. Well, as you know, we've had some discussions about it. You know that I've been practicing and stuff. I think you only saw me practice maybe like once, but you still didn't have a concept of really what it is, but you knew I was on some type of path. And basically what it is, it's dice control. That's just the name of it, okay? That's what just people refer to it as dice control, but it's not really control of dice. It's more the influence of dice, okay? And what it is, it relates back to what you would do as a player when you go to a Las Vegas style casino or a casino where there's a legitimate regulation style craps table, okay? And what it is, it's a shooting technique that you do as a player so that you can get an edge over the house, so that when you play craps, you're doing a certain type of controlled shot so that you as a player can gain an edge over the house, okay? Now, let me try to explain a little bit simpler so that you kind of understand what I'm saying. Basically, what dice control is, and like I said, it's more influencing of dice. It's not like control of the dice. And what I mean by that is, if you've ever been in a casino, what you're going to do, and you're playing craps, the idea is to shoot as many numbers as you possibly can and have as long a roll as you possibly can so that you as a player can win more money. Okay? So the longer you can shoot the dice without hitting the seven, which is what we refer to as the devil, if the further you can stay away from the seven, the longer your rolls will be and the better an opportunity you will have as a player to win money from the casino. Okay? So what you do as a dice controller is you're using a specialized setting of the dice and then a specialized controlled shot, very similar to a controlled golf swing, okay? So that when the dice are thrown into the air, they hit the layout, they hit the back wall, and come off of the back wall, they hit and they don't randomize as much, and you stay away from the seven so that you can have longer rolls. That's basically, in a nutshell, what dice controlled shooting is.
All right, so avoid the devil. All right, so next question. How was dice control invented?
Okay, sometime back in the early 90s, a gentleman by the name of Chris Policki, he had this idea that you could basically because he was an engineer, I think he was a mathematician and an engineer, he had this idea that he would be able to come up with a way of figuring out a throw that would accommodate a dice toss so that there's less avoidance, so that you can avoid the seven so that you would have longer rolls. And through trial and error, he invented a way of setting the dice, in other words, putting the dice on certain numbers and then picking them up a certain way and then tossing them a certain way so that you would have long, as a player, you would have longer rolls, which would give you the edge over the casino and an opportunity for you as the player to have an advantage over the casino and win more money. And Chris Pawlicki is considered the grandfather or the father of what we call modern dice control revolution. He was the one that started it. His nickname is Sharpshooter. Obviously, you can go online and look up about, you know, you can obviously go to Google and just punch in dice control and it'll all come up. But he was definitely the one that started the whole thing. It was back in the 90s.
Oh, okay.
Early 90s.
Very interesting. If you want, guys, like he said, Google that information. Well, here's a question. Can anyone learn dice control?
Yes. Anybody can attempt to learn it, but here's the problem. This is the inherent problem that's built into dice control, is it takes a lot of practice, okay? Now, in the world of casino gambling, now, we are fortunate enough because we both live here in Vegas. We can go to a casino at any given day of the week, any minute of the day. We can be in a casino within a matter of minutes, okay? For us, we have an advantage because we're here. Anytime we want to go test our skill, we can get into a car. Within a few minutes, we're at a casino. Versus people that don't live near a casino, they have to drive either an hour or they have to get on a plane to arrive at a casino. For us, it's easier, so we'll be able to test our skill a lot faster versus people that have to drive or fly. Okay. Now, anybody can attempt to learn dice control, but again, the inherent problem with it is it takes a lot of practice. A lot of practice. I mean, it's not something you're going to learn overnight. You can learn the basic concepts in a 3-day period. You can learn the concepts, learn how to set dice, learn how to do the basic toss. You can learn that in a 3-day weekend class seminar situation. But to actually get good at it and actually to be able to get a control or some type of influence over the dice, it's going to take you an average 6 months. And that's everyday practice, a minimum 3 hours a day for 6 months. I've been doing this going on 10 months now, and as of the last few weeks, for the last 10 months, I have practiced every single day.
Wow.
For a minimum an hour every single day. And there was times when I first started, I would practice 5 and 6 hours a day.
Wow. And then, like you said, it's very important to be able to field test these things, like just like with anything.
Right.
So, let me see. Now, that being said, then how did you learn dice control?
Basically, the way I learned it was I had heard about it through a television special that I had seen a few years ago. It was a show called Breaking Vegas, where they spotlighted a guy named Dom the Dominator, Luigio, or I think is his last name. They call him the Dice Dominator, and that was the name of the show. It was Breaking Vegas, the Dice Dominator. And what Breaking Vegas was a show that I think it was History Channel put it out, and it was all these different stories about all these people, how they basically broke Vegas. Either they cheated their way, either in a blackjack table or a roulette scam or something like that, and they spotlighted the Dice Dominator and his cohort, a guy named Frank Scobletti, and they did a show on these guys, and you know, and also Chris Pawlicki's in the show as well, and that's how I had heard about it, and it was only up until just 10 months ago that I actually fell across it again and decided I would look into it more and actually start doing it myself. But they were the ones, Frank and Dom were the ones that really put it out there in the public eye, to where it's becoming kind of like a casino well-known thing now, okay? And they sell videos. I actually have some videos up on my YouTube channel where you can go learn some stuff on as well about dice control. You can go on the internet. There's tons of stuff on YouTube. There's tons of stuff written up on the dice control subject, just on all over the internet. There's lots of people to talk about it. But here's the thing, and this is what's going to get a lot of people. And I don't want to try. I'm trying not to ramble on as much, but I think I need to give you as much information as possible.
Well, that's the name of this program, the Royal Ramblings.
The Royal Ramblings. So I'm in the right spot.
There you go.
Okay. So basically, one of the things that you are going to hit on almost immediately when you start learning about dice control is does it work or it doesn't work? And there's a lot of people in this underground subculture of people that do this or that know about it. There's a divided community, basically. Basically, some people absolutely believe it works, and then there are other people that absolutely believe it does not work, okay? And the reason why a lot of people believe that it doesn't work is because if you're ever at a casino and you're at a craps table and you look very closely at the craps table, you will notice the back wall. Now, the rule is on every casino that you go into is the dice, both dice must hit the back wall, okay? Now, if you look at the back wall very, very closely, you will notice that it has a bunch of little pyramids all on this rubber backing that goes all around the back edge of the table. And this is what we call alligator back, okay? And it's all these little pyramids, okay? And they're built a certain way so that when you throw the dice will hit onto one of these points and shoot the dice in a very randomized way all over the table, so it scatters the dice, okay? So a lot of people believe that once those dice hit that back wall and hit those pyramids, it is no longer a controlled shot, simply because those pyramids break up the control that you had over the dice, and it makes it become random. So you have a lot of people that believe it does work, and then you have a lot of people that believe it does not work, okay? I obviously believe it works. I know it works. I've seen it. You actually saw it tonight.
Yeah, I was going to say, I mean, I wasn't so sure what I believe, but I always want to go into things with an open mind, and I got to tell everybody who's watching and listening to this, I believe it because actions speak louder than words, and I saw it with my own two eyes.
And so, how long was I on the table shooting?
God, it must have been.
Tell us some of the experiences that you saw for someone that's never been at a craps table and seen it from that perspective by a guy who you have been longtime friends with. You've only seen it one time in practice, but in live play, this was the very first time you saw it. What did you think? Tell us your experiences on it.
It's true. I'm not a gambler. I mean, you know, other than those of you that have watched the ramblings on my marriage. But I've never been on a craps table, and this was the first time, other than the practice session that we went through, where I was able to see this technique. And, you know...
And that's a perfect name, because it is a technique.
Yeah, I mean, it's definitely a technique. You know, not knowing the game at all, just witnessing what I saw, I was able to see my friend, when it was his turn to shoot, the specific way that he handles the dice, the specific way that he tosses the dice. And some of you out there will be saying, oh, well, it's all just, you know, a bunch of randomized bull, you know, shit, so to speak, or whatever. But you have to know the difference between what some of you, many of you would refer to as luck, and actually seeing this done not just once, not twice, but over and over and over again, to such success that not only myself, but all the people at the table, including the dealers, were blown away by this experience. And I was moved by it. I was like, wow. Like,
how long was I shooting?
It must have been at least 40, 45 minutes.
How long? How many numbers do you think I threw?
It had to go into the, well into the, what, like, almost 30-ish.
I would maybe. Say I was in the 30-ish somewhere. We didn't count, but I know that I figured I was somewhere in the high 30s. Easy.
Yeah, I was blown away because I would have expected easily for a 7 to come up, but it never did. I mean, eventually did, but took a long time.
And you saw me hitting repeat numbers? I mean, you saw me, I probably hit 5 or 6 points.
Yeah.
You saw me hitting how many different hard ways, like 3-3 and 4-4 and,
yeah,
you know, 5-5s. I hit many of those. The guy that beside you was freaking out.
Yeah, yeah, he wasn't the only one. I was freaking out. Everybody was freaking out. It was. If you guys could have experienced it, it was very cool. It was a very nice,
you know,
amazing moment.
I mean, I'm really passionate about this. I mean, I love this to death.
Really? No.
and you know, and I was really happy that you actually had a chance to see it for the very first time, because you know that I've basically been in a cocoon for 10 months. I mean, you pretty much know that. And now you know what I've been doing for the last 10 months, just literally practicing my ass off.
Right,
and,
right.
And you saw the fruits of my labor today, and I took a very small amount of money and I quadrupled it.
Yeah.
Not doubled it or made 20% off of my buy-in. I quadrupled my money.
Yeah, that's absolutely true. I mean, I was there. I bear witness to it. So I know it's true, guys. And for those of you that, you know, might be saying, you know, you're not sure, or even being very negative and saying, you know, like I said, this is bullshit, give it a try. I mean, definitely going to check out. I wanted to roll into talking, because you mentioned it,
mm-hmm,
about your YouTube videos and stuff. You have some YouTube videos on dice control, if you want to give the,
yeah,
the YouTube account or whatnot.
Yeah, not a problem. So basically, like I said, you know, if you decide you're really going to take an interest in this, you obviously have to realize that you're either going to believe it or you're not going to believe it. And that's going to be the hardest thing is if you decide that you are going to be of an open mind and you're going to give it a legitimate, hardcore, 6-month try before you make any kind of judgment call, if it works or it doesn't, you have to at least give at least 6 months of everyday practice, a minimum of 3 hours a day, before you can say yes, it works, or no, it doesn't work. Once you get past that, once you've learned how to shoot and how to throw the dice and how to set them and understand the principles of the grip, the toss, the setting, the standing positions that you're in. Once you understand all that and you give it a legitimate 6 months effort to see if it works or it doesn't work, you're going to find out for yourself. Unless you're extremely, extremely uncoordinated, you will not pull it off. But if you're pretty coordinated, you can throw a baseball pretty well. Maybe you can throw a knife into a wall. You know, I know that there's a lot of people on YouTube that they like to, you know, play around with the balisong knives, and they have this whole skill about it. And the guys that flick around cards and do the magic and stuff. You know, guys that play guitar real intricately. Guys that, you know, play piano real intricately. People that play drums. And you see all these wonderful skills on YouTube. If you're willing to put that type of devotion into it, and you have that kind of inherent built-in ability, this will work for you if you put in the time and effort. I totally 100% believe that you'll be able to pull it off. Now, there's a lot of resources on dice control. If you go on YouTube, you can punch in the eight physical elements of dice control. They're free YouTube videos. And I think it's a 4-part series, and it's by Frank and Dom. They're the Golden Touch guys. They were the one that popularized dice control as we know it today. Those videos will teach you how to shoot a controlled shot. And then once you learn from those videos, if you decide you want to go to their website and buy their full DVD set, you can do that. Or you can follow my channel. I have a channel. I'm Koga Ninja 777, all one word. Koga Ninja 777, and I have a bunch of videos on there, and I continue to update. When people send me, hey, what about this, or can you answer this, or can you make a video of this, I will be more than happy to answer the question. If not, I'll make a video specifically for it if I believe that it has enough merit to be shown on YouTube. I'll put it up there. And there's a lot of great information on just my videos alone, a lot. I teach you how to build a practice rig out of a cardboard box to get you going, so you're not investing a lot of money. You're going down to Walmart and you're getting a cardboard box, or going into an alleyway behind some stores and picking up a box. I teach you how to cut it up. Actually, that video is not up right now, but I'm gonna recut a video and put it up there just on specifically how to make a practice dice rig out of a controlled, out of a cardboard box. The only thing that you will need is you will need to invest in some dice, some casino dice. You can go online and there's a whole bunch of gambling supply houses. Just punch in casino gambling supplies and they'll all come up, and then just get yourself some real casino dice. That's it, and you're off to the races.
Right, so there's no instant gratification is what he's saying. You got to put in practice, just like with anything worthwhile. But there's a lot of things on Google, and there's a lot of different YouTube channels. Again, if you want Koga Ninja 777, I'll probably put up a link here at some point. But that being said, also, I wanted to roll into, because we were talking about your YouTube videos. Now, you mentioned investing in some dice, some casino dice. I understand out of the videos that you have on your YouTube channel, some of your videos are controversial videos that might be in line with what we were actually talking about.
It's because of those videos. There's two reasons why you don't see my face.
Yeah, we were talking about earlier why we couldn't see his face. So.
You mentioned that to me, while we're looking through my channel, you had also mentioned, you were like, what's the deal with these unbalanced dice videos?
Yeah, the dirt.
The dirt. And so I went ahead and showed them to you and kind of explained what they were about. And it's pretty disturbing stuff, isn't it? I mean, seriously, what do you think?
Seriously, in all honest to God, guys, you know, all joking aside, this is some very serious stuff. And It's more than disturbing. I mean, I'll let you explain.
So it's because of these videos. There's two reasons why you don't see my face in any of my videos. It's because, and also too, this is not my real voice. I mean, I've got a disguiser on just to let you know. So, in all my videos, my voice is disguised, so you would never know it's me. So, these videos. Specifically because of these two videos where I'm talking about unbalanced dice, I definitely don't want my face shown. That's the first reason, okay? I'm going to get into exactly why, but because of those two videos, I don't want my face shown, because it's a very, very taboo type of subject matter, okay? Especially for guys that are in the underground dice controlled shooting world, if you will, okay? This underground subculture of dice controllers, okay? Very taboo subject matter. And the second reason why you don't see me on second reason you don't see my face on any of my videos is because I don't want the casinos knowing who I am, okay? And simply because they have what is known as face recognition systems. It's called the Griffin system, and they can take any photograph, picture, digitized image, and put it and scan it and put it into their system, and that system will recognize your face when you go into a casino. And if they see you in a casino and they know that you're a controlled shooter, they're gonna ask you to leave, okay? And I don't want to be banned from any casinos, and that's why you don't see my face. Now. People, I know what people are going to ask. Well, if you can see it on your, if they're going to kick you out because they see your face, then it's illegal. Dice control is illegal. First off, dice control is not illegal. It's legal, okay? It's like card counting. Card counting is legal, but it's not highly looked upon. And they will ask you to leave, okay? Now, I've talked to many casino personnel. Okay, and I've only had one casino personnel admit that they know for a fact that dice control works. Okay, most casino personnel, by and large, 99% of them will tell you that dice control does not work. Okay, the reality is it's misinformation. It does work, and they know it works, and they're afraid of really good dice shooters. Here's the thing. Most guys that go in to attempt dice control will fail. Nine out of 10 people that attempt it will fail at dice control, simply because they do not put in the practice to learn how to do it properly. It's very, very difficult. But if you put in the practice, you can be deadly toward a casino, especially if you're putting in a lot of money. Like tonight when I played and you had a chance to see me, it was not, I didn't put a whole lot of money. I quadrupled my money, but just imagine if I was betting, you know, $1,000 or $500 a hand or $100 a hand, I would have been hauled out of there pretty quick because I was killing it. I mean, I was on, and they knew it, okay? And they were doing little tricks and little things to try to get me off the table, but didn't work. They didn't break my concentration, okay? So, but by and large, most casino personnel are going to tell you that dice control is bullshit. It doesn't work. It's a myth. But the fact of the matter is it does work. They know it works, and it's just misinformation because they don't want real good shooters going in there and getting advantage on them. They just don't. So I know this for a fact because I've talked to casino personnel, and I finally got one to admit it. Yes, it does work. We're afraid of it. We don't like it, but it is what it is, okay? And usually what happens is you'll have a dice controller. Most dice controllers that go in there, certain casinos really sweat these guys, really sweat dice controllers, and they'll go in there and they'll start shooting and they seven out real quick. And say, this guy's a poser, he's a wannabe. But then you have guys that really know what the hell they're doing and they're good at what they're doing, and they start getting heat real fast. And a lot of times they get kicked out. So that is why you don't see my face. You'll never know my real voice, all of that. So, and now getting back to the controversial videos that I have up on YouTube, you had asked me what they were about. I showed them to you. Really disturbing stuff. And here's basically what it is. Okay. I don't mean to diss anybody. I'm not pointing fingers. I'm not saying this. I'm not saying that. All I'm saying, and I'm not accusing anybody of anything, and I'm not accusing the casinos of anything either. I'm just saying that the information that I found on YouTube, some information that I found on YouTube about unbalanced dice being used in casinos in Las Vegas, I found out about it, I read about it, and I did my own test, and lo and behold, there are dice that are being used in casinos in Las Vegas that are unbalanced. Now, what does that mean? That basically means that dice manufacturers are producing dice that are not properly balanced. So when the dice get into casino play, those dice are unfair, meaning you will end up with more 7 and 11s or more 5 2s or more 3, 4, 7 outs. And that gives you, the player, an unfair test against the casino. So you already got the house edge against you. On top of that, you got unfair dice that you gotta deal with that makes your house edge go through the roof. So basically what I'm saying is the casino's got the edge on you, big time, especially when they're using unfair dice, okay? Now, with the unfair dice, what happens is when you start playing, what's gonna happen is when you're a random thrower, what happens is you end up sevening out a lot faster than probability dictates. Probability dictates that for every 6 times that you roll the dice, a 7 will appear with fair dice. With unfair dice, that number goes up higher. It could be 3-6. It could be 2-6. It could be 4-6. It just all depends how unbalanced these dice are. Okay, when they're unbalanced dice, it changes the game. It gives more casino. It gives the casinos a higher outhouse edge against you, and it lowers your possibility as a player to win. Okay, now I've gotten reports through my videos. I've created a lot of controversy with these videos. Okay, and I've had scientists tell me that I'm full of shit. I don't know what I'm talking about. That these videos are very flawed. That I didn't do it. I didn't do the test properly. I've had people come out of the woodwork and basically shit all over my videos and tell me that the information that I'm presenting is false and it's fake, and that the casinos have the people's best interests at heart, and that you are playing a fair game, that they are playing a fair game, and that they would never attempt to cheat their customers because they're afraid that the gaming board is going to take their license away. Let me tell you straight up, it's fucking bullshit. It ain't going to happen. The Nevada Gaming Board knows that there's unbalanced dice in play, and they don't care, and they have not fixed the problem. Their stand is that it is up to the casino to properly check the dice before it goes into play. Unfucking believable. And I mean, it's crazy. I actually had a buddy of mine who is a dealer in another state. I'm not going to say what state, okay? In their state, they have fair dice. Fair dice. And he commented on my videos. He sent me a private email. We talked about it. He told me about the procedure of how they test dice. He told me flat out that my testing procedure on both of my videos were 100% dead on balls accurate, and that the dice that we use in Vegas, that he really felt bad that it sucked that we were having to deal with unfair dice, and that the state that he plays in and deals in is 100% legit. And I was like, wow. And this is a casino insider that told me this. This is true. I have no fucking reason to lie to anybody and tell them that, you know, the casinos are using bad dice. Why would I do that? It benefits me in no way, shape, fashion, and form to step on somebody's dream of winning some cash at a casino. I'm not winning anything from it. I'm not gaining any money from it. So when people tell me that my testing theories is flawed, that's ridiculous. That's completely, completely ridiculous. All I did with these videos is show that there are unfair dice being used in Las Vegas, and that you, as a dice-controlled shooter or a random shooter that wants to play a fair game in Vegas, you need to be aware of it, because there are unfair dice in Vegas right now as we speak being played live. It is what it is. I don't give a shit if you're hold a PhD, you know everything about numbers, you can scientific my ass up and down the block. The proof is in the pudding. It doesn't take a rocket scientist to figure out, I'm going to put this little die in this little caliper, spin it, and if it spins unfairly, it is what it is. It's not that difficult. You don't have to spin the dice 20,000 times and record it to see that it's off. That's retarded. That's just retarded. Okay?
One spin and watch what the die is going to do.
These videos, the Nevada Gaming Board knows of the problem. I even got reports from somebody that actually, this guy told me through some email correspondence that he actually met, so I couldn't remember if it was a casino personnel, like a high-end pit boss executive, or no, it was somebody in the Nevada Gaming Board in that region somewhere. I don't know exactly. He specifically admitted that we have a lot of problems with 6-1-7 ounce, but they can't do anything about it. They won't do anything about it. It's the craziest thing. I think the problem is that through the manufacturing of the dice, that they don't put enough quality control in the way that the dice are balanced out, the way that they make them. And the problem is not in the cube itself, it's the pips, what causes the 7 ounce. In other words, causes the weight to be distributed throughout the dice unevenly. You know, it would be like if you put one penny and then right next to it you put two pennies and then right next to it you put three pennies all the way down to six pennies and you weighed each one of those pennies, those sets of pennies, what's going to be more heavy? The six pennies. I mean, logic dictates that, right? Okay, so basically what you have to do So basically what dice manufacturers have to do is they have to basically make the 1 and the 6 properly even out when they form the pips, when they put the pips. How would they design it? I don't know. But they got to do something to even that out. So, but they haven't done it. And it's aware, the Nevada Gaming Board's aware of it, and their stand is we've washed our hands of it, basically. Until somebody comes forward that know, like a whistleblower, until he comes forward, then maybe something will be done. But until then, nothing's going to be done. Now, how do we, as dice controllers, combat that? I will be releasing a video very soon on a technique to combat that so that you get more of a fair game. And another way of doing it is charting the table. When you chart the table, you just take numbers. You record all the numbers from all the different players as the dice go around. Every throw of the dice is recorded. And then you just catalog the numbers and you just look and see what numbers are coming up more often than not. And then if you see that the dice are being unfair to you, you don't play that casino. That's really basically it.
All right.
So
to recap, guys, it's definitely the city of sin. You know, I mean, to quote a movie, The Hangover, it's not illegal to do dice control or card counting or whatnot. It's frowned upon, but it's not illegal. I mean, the corporations nowadays, they make the mafia look like choir boys anyway, because they have their own little games. Like we were saying, and I witnessed it, they'll try to stop you. They have their own little tricks that they do to try to make you, you know, mess up or get flustered, but it's not really illegal for you to do it. I mean, what were they doing tonight, to quote the Karate Kid? The pit boss comes by and whispers to the dealer, I want you to sweep the leg. Well, I can take this dice shooter. I don't want him taken. I want him destroyed. Sweep the leg. You know, that's pretty much
and
it.
And it's true. they were doing a very popular little trick called the 4-1 trick, which is where they get a die, when they're passing the dice out to you after you've established a number, they will send the dice, the stick man will send the dice out to you where one die has a 4 on it, so you see 4 pips, and then one's on the other die is a 1, so it's a 4-1 combination, and they will send that out to you. Now if you pick up those dice and launch them, there's about an 80% chance that you're going to 7 out immediately after. And we know this to be true. We know this. I know this as a dice controller because I've talked to people that are in the know. I'm not some fucking idiot here. I know what's going on, okay? We know. We've got firsthand information that says that dice, that craps dealers will use the 4-1 dice technique to try to make you 7 out. 80% of the time it works. And this is a common practice throughout all the casinos. All the casinos do this, okay? And we know this because we talked to somebody who's a craps dealer, and that person told us exactly what they do to try to knock off people, in other words, to make them 7 out when they're having a good roll, either it be a controlled shooter or some random guy or random lady who's on a great roll. And that's what they were doing to me all night tonight. It didn't work because I know the secret of how to bypass that.
Right, right.
And you saw it after I mentioned it to you. You saw it several times after the fact.
Oh, yeah. You can see it in their eyes, folks. All right, so that being said, we've got a lot of information there. Those of you who are going to go on his YouTube channel and so forth, there's going to be more videos coming on that. Any last-minute comments on any of this?
I would definitely say... If you are a gambler and you're shooting craps, I think that you should be using getting an advantage on the casinos, and you should be using some type of controlled shot. There's many different types of controlled shots. I would say if you're really interested in it, start looking up dice control on the internet, pull down some videos, go to my channel, Koga Ninja 777, all one word. Go to my channel, follow me, post comments, tell me what you want to see. I'll make a video of it if I feel that it's relevant. There's a lot of good information, and the Golden Touch guys, they put out their, they teach you how to do a controlled shot in the 8 physical elements of dice control on YouTube, and those are free videos. And that, they give you the whole enchilada right there. They teach you how to do it. And so, yeah, I mean, there's a lot of great information. If you ever come out to Vegas and you want to do a lesson with me, I'll be more than happy to give you a lesson. There's some really good shooters around, and yes, it works. You know, yes, there's bad dice in casinos. There's a way to combat that. I'm not pointing any fingers at anybody, and I'm not accusing anybody of anything. I'm just making people aware, and it is what it is. I love the game. I'm going to continue to play it, and there's no stopping me, man, and I hope to see more people at the table with the mindset that they know they can shoot control, and they can take some money home with them and have a great fucking time when they're playing.
All right, that's it. Don't hate the player, hate the game. Don't hate the dice control shooter, hate the casinos.
You go, man. You said it the best.
That being said, guys, that's it for this edition of the Royal Ramblings. Thank you for tuning in, and stay tuned for next time on the Royal Ramblings.
What's up? This is Koga Ninja, and I'm back with another video. This time today, I'm going to be talking about the grip.